Hi children, good morning. Welcome to today's reading time. Today I'm going to tell you the story of the Naughty Goes to Toyland. It was written by Bash Ghosh. This story in the woods near Toyland, Big Ears was furiously riding his little red bicycle. He suddenly crashed into someone. Down they fell and the bicycle landed on them with a loud crash. Big Ears had big pointed ears and wore red striped pants. He then saw who he had bumped into. "You are a strange looking man," Big Ears told him, staring. "What are you? You don't look like a pixie or a brownie or a goblin." Big Ears was confused. He had not seen anyone like this little man. "No," was all he said, nodding his head. Big Ears then asked him if he was a toy. He again said no. The strange man's head nodded again. Big Ears was not sure what to make of this man, and he found his nodding head quite peculiar. He asked him, "Why do you nod your head when you say no?" The little nodding man then explained that his head was made out of wood, and it was attached to his shoulders in such a manner that it nodded when he spoke. The little man then added that it nodded even. Suddenly, a mouse ran past the little man. He became very scared. The little man asked Big Ears, "Who was that? Is it following me?" he asked, frightened. Big Ears said, "It's just a field mouse. Is somebody following you?" The little man told Big Ears that he had run away. That is why he thought that somebody was following him. "I belong to an old carver who lives in the woods," the little man told him. Big Ears was surprised and asked him why he ran away. The little man said that he became very lonely there, and also because the old man was carving a lion. "See, I do not like lions very much." Out of curiosity, Big Ears asked how he was made. The strange man began a story. "He first made wooden feet and then wooden legs. Then the old carver made a round body of wood, and then arms and legs of wood too. Then a wooden neck and a round wooden head." "What are your eyes made of?" Big Ears asked. The little man told him that the eyes were made of blue beads and his hair was made of bits of fur. The hair came from the old man's carver's cat. Big Ears was very amused at this. Big Ears did not understand why the little man ran away. So he asked him why he chose to run. The strange man told him, "I want to go to somewhere where there are lots of people. I want to live with people." Big Ears told him that he was going to Toyland. Toyland was a place where all the toys lived together. Big Ears told him that since the little man was not a brownie or a goblin, he would be welcomed there. Big Ears also told the little man that he could come with him to Toyland if he wanted to. "But I do not know the way," the little man said sadly. Big Ears told him that not to worry, as Big Ears knew the way. If they hurried to the nearby station, they could catch a train to Toyland. The little man was very happy. Then Big Ears helped the strange man on his bicycle and told him to hold tight. Big Ears paddled him a bicycle with all his might and raced towards the train station. The poor little wooden man almost fell off a few times. While riding his bicycle, Big Ears asked the little man what was his name. To that, the little man said he did not have a name. "I think your name is Naughty," Big Ears said after a lot of thought. "I think it is," said Naughty happily. Naughty and Big Ears could hear the train whistling nearby. They hurried to the train station. Soon they rode into the station at top speed, just in time for the train. The train was thundering in. "All aboard for Toyland, all aboard for Toyland,"
cried a voice on top of all the noise. Thank you, children. I hope you all enjoy the story.
See you in the next reading time.